Hi, I'm Dr. Branyon with New Hope Unlimited. Thanks for joining me. The other day we talked about how I have certain favorite cancer fighter cells that's in the immune system that you already have. Sometimes it just needs to be expanded upon in order to make you that big fighting army that is a natural army and of your own DNA that you need. Well, today I want to talk about the professional cytotoxic T cell. Now, T cells, whether they're CD8, CD4, cytotoxic T cells, whatever, they all are just like any of the fighter cells, the natural killers, the dendritics, B cells, T cells, any of those, they first originate or start in the bone marrow. So the bone is what houses the marrow. Just like if you were to look inside of a ham bone, you're going to see that old grayish material. That's what our bone marrow looks like too. But inside that bone marrow is all the beginnings of the hematopoietic, the progenitors, the mesenchymals, all the stem cells that we have. That's the very life beginning right there in that marrow. But what happens is the professional cytotoxic cell, and notice I call it professional because it has one job, one innate ability to know what it's going to do and what it wants to do, and it has fun doing it. And as I've told you, I love putting personalities to them because they have personalities. Well, that's the layman way of speaking about it. The research scientist will speak it another term, but that sometimes can float over our heads. And I want to make this to where you can understand it. So just like Einstein says, imagination is very important. So if I can get your imagination to moving so that when you're just sitting around and you can start thinking about those dendritics or those natural killer cells and those cytotoxic cells, then you can start playing and imagining what they can do inside. Well, these cytotoxic cells begin in the bone marrow and then they do their certain things and then they go into the bloodstream. And then they in the bloodstream will go to the thymus gland. That's where they end up first. Once they come out of the bone marrow, they'll end up in the thymus, because in the thymus they have to mature a little better so that they can do the job that they need to be doing. So once they kind of figure out that they don't really want to be a CD8 cell or a CD4 cell or a B cell, then when they figure out, hey, I'm ready to go in and be a cytotoxic T cell, then they will start working on different type serums, and they will go in and they will go through a different specification of making their serums called capace, and there is all the different ones, but they end up with what they call the caspase 8. That is the deadly serum. That's the hemlock of Romeo and Juliet. That's the poison that's going to kill those cancer cells. Now remember, we have on every cancer cell, it depends on the type of cancer, your DNA, many things, but every cancer cell will get that special coding, enzyme coding. It's kind of like the HCG coding of a pregnant lady around the uterus, but it will get that special coding. And then what happens is it will also get what they call tumor surface antigens. Now, tumor surface antigens are going to be different from any other type cancer. It's going to depend on your type cancer, because remember, we're talking DNA. So even the antigens are not going to be the same as everybody else's tumor surface antigens. Now, I must say that antigens are bad. You don't want those. You want lots of antibodies that can go in and get the antigens. But we're going to talk about that another day. Today, we're going to talk about the cytotoxic T cell. Cytotoxic means exactly what it says, cytotoxic. It's very toxic to those cancer cells. But what they'll do, they'll roam the blood and the lymph system, and they're looking for those cancer cells. Now, when the cytotoxic cancer cell all of a sudden floats by and sees the cancer cell, it'll bind to that cancer cell's tumor surface antigens, and which has a MCH combination, and then those cytotoxic cells moves in for the no mercy killing. I know it sounds a little negative, but that's what you want right now. You want that army to fight for you. So that cytotoxic goes in for that no mercy. It's got one job, and it's going to make that happen for you. That's why these are so important. So it'll go in for that killing. And what it will do, it will bind, and then it will start releasing those special enzymes like the caspase 8, and it starts punching holes all into that cancer cell membrane, which causes apoptosis. Now, what does apoptosis mean? Apoptosis means cell death. In this video, we're talking cancer cell death. So it goes in for the killing, it binds, it starts releasing all of its killer enzymes, and all of a sudden that cancer cell starts dying. Now here's the weird thing about it, an amazing thing about it. It has that personality of type A, I'm gonna do this, I'm not gonna let this beat me, I'm gonna do it, and then when it does it, it's so puffed up and proud of what it has done, it will pull pieces off of that dead cancer cell and bind to itself. It's kind of like wearing the clothing of what it has done. And then it will go along about its happy, merry way into the bloodstream, and it's like showing off. Look, look what I've done. Look, see, I won. I told you I would do it because that's what I've been made to do. So it runs around and it shows off all the other fighter cells. I did it. Can you do it? I did it. And then eventually all the other little cells like the macrophages and phagocytes, they'll come in and they'll start eating up all that rotten material off of it. And then we digest it. We digest, and when we digest anything, whether we eat, put it on our skin, spray, breathe, whatever those toxic things are, which the dying material of the cancer cell can be toxic. And that can make you sick if your detoxification units are not working in your body. But it starts pulling it off, eating it up, and we send it through the liver. Our liver is very, very important, and it will send it through and digest more, and then we'll filter it out by either pooping it out or sweating it out or urinating, peeing it out, and then we're done with it. But now, these cytotoxic cells do have memory, so they can multiply and divide, and when they do that, they'll have memory, and that says, oh, I'm gonna go look for what grandfather looked for or grandmother looked for. So they go out and they do it again. You know, we are such marvelous people and we don't even know it. So I want you to start thinking about how unbelievable you are. You are today what you thought you were yesterday. Therefore, you will be tomorrow what you think you are today. So today is another day. Start thinking, I am amazing. My immune system is working better and better. I am happier today than I was yesterday. So tomorrow, we'll work on it again. Hope this made a little bit of sense to you. You can look it up. You can see that the facts are there. I just made it a little into some drama for you so it can be thought about in a way that you can use it in your imagination. Bring out the little girls and the little boys and have fun. What if it saves your life? Wouldn't it be worth it? Thank you. See you on the next one.